Morning student. So today we will start our next chapter, that is acid, bases and salts. Okay. So what are the topics that we are gonna cover? So we're gonna cover its introduction, acids, bases, indicators and neutralization. Okay, so this we're gonna cover in this chapter and as well as the examples from our daily life. So first we want to see that what we have to learn about acid, bases and salt. What are they? What are acids? What are bases? And what are salts? And how they play a role in our day-to-day life. Okay. So let's first see, where do we find acids and bases? Now acid and bases, even though their name look common, but actually these are very common solutions which exist everywhere. A lot of liquids that we use or we counter on day-to-day our life, they may be acidic or basic in their nature. Okay, so let us look at some of the some of such things which we come across very very quickly. So and that contain acid and base or salt. Okay, so one such thing is the lemon or citrus fruit. Okay, oranges, limes, etc. They are called citrus fruits because they contain acid. They are called citrus fruit because they have an acid called citric acid, and because of this they are called citrus fruits. Okay, you think of something like vinegar. So do you think what exactly is vinegar is? It is the watery liquid which mostly used for cooking Chinese dishes like chowmein, and vinegar is used that time. It is commonly used there. So it is also an acid, that is acetic acid. Okay, because it is acidic in nature. You think of soft drinks, Coke, Pepsi, Fanta, Coca-Cola. So what are these? So these soft drinks are also acids, as they contain carbonic acid. So they are also acidic in nature. Think of something like soda, baking soda, which is used for preparing things like baking. For example, while baking a cake, we put some baking powder in it. Okay, in fact, a lot of other things. Or you can heard about washing soda, which is used for washing clothes. So they are also not acidic. They are basic in nature. Okay, they contain base, so they are basic in nature. Okay, sometimes when you eat a lot of junk food or oily food, okay, and not hygienic food, what happens? You are having a digestion problem or stomach problem. So you feel discomfortable, and what do you do then? So we use something which remove our acidity, okay, in our stomach. So how do you remove the acid? With the help of antacids tablets. So these antacids tablets, they are again antacid, that means that contain acid. Sorry, they contain a base. Okay, it is not necessary that it has to be either acidic or basic, but there are some other substances which neither acidic nor basic. They are called sugar or salt. Okay, they are neither acidic nor basic. We can take an example of water. Water is neither acid nor basic. It's neutral. Okay. So those are some substances which are either acid or base or neutral. Okay. Now we'll talk about soap. What do you think? Soap is acid or base? So that soap is for washing, which we use for washing purpose. So all the soaps, they contain base. Okay, they are basic in nature. Soap, bleaches, they are all basic in nature. So you see, all these things are very common and which we use in our day-to-day life, and they contain either acid or base. But there are a lot of them contain neither of them. A lot of items which are edible, which we consume, they also contain acid or base. For example, curd. So we all consume curd, even in raw form or in another type of dishes, but curd also contain an acid, lactic acid. Okay, we all eat spinach. Spinach is also acidic in nature and contain oxalic acid. Okay, so there are so many things which contain acid or base. Now we really want to know what are acids and base and what are their characteristics. So we let us know about this. So let us now see what are acids. Now the word acid is derived from the Latin word acid, which means sour. Acid, which means sour. So now does that imply that acid are those substances which are sour in taste? Well, to some extent. Okay, so these acids, they are sour in taste. Let's say take some example, which for example, like lemon and oranges, we all have tasted it and we all know that they are sour in taste and they are acidic because they contain an acid called citric acid. Okay, now we take another example, vinegar. Okay, if not, you can taste it. It is also sour in taste. Okay, and vinegar contain acid called acetic acid. Okay, let's take another example. Let's take a very common example. Our body. What is that made up of? What is our body made up of? Our body contain a lot of proteins. And what are proteins made up of? Proteins are made up of amino acids. Okay, and what is it? Acid again. So protein are also made up of acid. So you see, protein, they play such an important role that they are in the form of amino acid in our entire body. Okay. So these proteins contain amino acid. Okay. Think of the process of digestion. In one of our previous lesson, we have learned about how the food digested in our stomach, how the pieces are broken down, and then absorption, assimilation have been taken place inside our body. Do you remember what happens in the stomach? Stomach contains hydrochloric acid, HCl, and this hydrochloric acid plays a very important role in our stomach because due to this acidic medium, the enzymes pepsin become active and help in the digestion of protein in the stomach. So HCl play a very important role in our stomach. So here also you see acid again. So inside our body also there are so many acid present. So when the concentration of this increases in our stomach, so we get acidity. So we then suffer from acidity. Okay, that's how the problem of acidity comes in our body. Okay, now you take an example of spinach. Spinach is also contain an acid, the oxalic acid. You take example of curd, which is consumed by us. It contain lactic acid. Okay, so all these common substances contain so much of acids. So it is really important to you to know. I would not say that the correct way of defining acid and base by its taste. We cannot say that by tasting we can identify that some things are acid or basic. but the only way to find the acid and base, but not by tasting. This is basically the characteristic of acid, that they are sour in taste, but we cannot identify each and everything by tasting it, whether it is sour or not. Okay, so this so we can because some acids are might be extremely harmful to consume, so we cannot consume it. So if the only way of defining acid and base, so this is basically one of the characteristics, but we can identify in another way. I will let you know about this also. But before this, now we can just read what are bases. Now our another topic is what are bases. So these are the substances which have been mostly bitter in taste. So let's take a few examples. They are also contain soapy in touch, not only bitter. They are soapy in touch. So soap is an example of base. It is bitter in taste and soapy to touch. Okay, it's slippery, na? It's slimy. So it is a base. Now, some other examples are bleach, the washing soda, baking soda, they are also bases. But if you have able to chance to get the chance to taste it, you can taste it. But don't do that. But if you taste baking soda little bit, it is bitter in taste. Okay. Now, just now I gave an example. When the concentration of hydrochloric acid in the stomach increases, what that causes acidity. And when you have acidity, you feel pain in the stomach or uneasiness, discomfort. And how we get rid of that? By using antacid tablets. So these antacid tablets, they are basic in nature. When we consume this tablet, that it goes to our stomach and reduces the acidity. Okay, they are just opposite to the just opposite of acid, and then neutralize everything in our stomach, and that is how we feel better after taking an antacid tablets. Okay, now these bases in initial days, they also play an in also known as alkaline. This is the term which we use those days. Alkaline is basically an Arabic word which means ashes of salt. Okay, it is a plant which is grow in a salt marshes. So that was how we earlier time we use as bases as an alkaline. We say bases as a alkaline, but now we can say bases only. Okay. Now there a question is, can there be substances which are neither basic nor acidic? Yes, of course there can be substances which are neither basic nor acidic in nature. They are called neutral. That means they are not neither acidic nor basic. Some of the examples are sugar, salt, water. These are all examples of neutral substances. So now in this lesson, we have to focus on acid, bases, and we are going to see how can we distinguish between an acid and a base. How can we determine a particular substance is an acid or a base? Okay, so that's the question which run in everybody's mind, how to distinguish acid and basic substances. Now tasting the substance is not a right solution, because we can never know that some new substance, you have to find out whether it is acidic or basic. You're not sure about it. Okay, But you want to know whether it is acidic or basic. So if you think that tasting the substances is an option, that can be risky as well. Because maybe the substance may be poisonous substance. So it is gonna cause you harm. So eating is not advisable to find out whether a substance is acid or base, because you never know. Okay. It might be contain a lot of harmful things which may spoil your body. So now we are going to find the other ways or an alternative ways which help us to distinguish between an acidic and basic substances. Okay. And that is where you caught, and that is indicators. So what are indicators? These are the substances which indicate whether a substance is acidic or basic in nature. Okay. Actually, these are normal substances. These substances react with acid or bases in different ways. Okay. And then find out whether a substance is acidic or basic. We can then just identify. It is a simple logic actually. Okay. It indicates. That is why it is called indicators. It shows us the change. Okay. When they come in contact of acidic or basic substances. Now basically these indicators, they change their color when added to specific substance, whether it is an acidic or basic. Okay. The color to which they change, that color indicates the nature of the substance. Now some of the naturally occurring indicators, like which already existed in nature, but they have some special property and act as an indicator. Some such examples are China rose, which is also known as hibiscus or gudhal. This China rose is an excellent indicator. Iske alawa, the turmeric, which you often find in your kitchen also. Okay. So litmus test. Next is litmus test. It is a kind of dye which obtained from a lichen. Lichen is mostly seen in a bark of a trees, and lichen is an associated symbiotic association with an algae and fungi. I have given you this question in unit test also. Okay, so that lichen. So from that litmus we obtain from litmus paper, and this litmus paper also show a change in the color when it comes to contact of acid or basic substances. Okay. So these are naturally occurring indicators, but there are many other which act as an acidic or which are indicator. One such example of this indicator, there are many chemical compound also which act as an indicator. One such example is the phenolphthalein. So this is a colorless chemical compound which act as an indicator. Now which is that property which is present in the in these substances so that they behave like an indicator? The substance should be able to change its color when it comes to contact of acidic or basic substances, and the change in the color in an acidic substance should be different in the change in the color in the basic substance. For example, when it come in contact with an acid, it become red in color. If it is acid, it come red in color, and if it is basic, then it become blue in color. Okay, so that is the only property which we are looking at to find the indicators. Okay, so I think this is enough for today, and we have already read what are acids, base, and what are indicators. Now we're gonna talk about litmus and how do we conduct the litmus test in our next class. Okay. Thank you.